Military restaurants are the rage in Namma Bengaluru, and they're known for serving hearty, robust, local non-vegetarian cuisine. And I'm here in Jayanagar, a suburb of Bengaluru, and I'm here to visit Ranganna Military Hotel, which has been around for the last 60 years. So let's go in and check out what a meal at Ranganna Military Hotel is all about. Let's go. You know, when you're standing outside, you've got the din, the hustle, the bustle, and the noise of the traffic. But when you walk into this fairly large, airy, and spacious room, it's quiet, it's almost peaceful, and you get the feeling that you're in for a great meal. Some very interesting pictures on the wall, and I'm told that the owner used to be a champion wrestler. If he was a wrestler, well, perhaps he focused a lot on what he was eating, and therefore perhaps also the focus on food here at Ranganna Military Hotel. So I'm with Sendil, who's the third generation owner of Ranganna Military Hotel. So Ranganna Military Hotel is very much a family affair. The third generation looks after the operation, the second generation, they cook the food.
Cook the food, yeah.
They do all the shopping, they do all the procurement, and I guess that's what makes family-run establishments like these so special. And that too, family-run establishments that have stood the test of time for nearly six decades. So it's an open kitchen, so customers can walk into the kitchen any point that they choose to take a look at how their food is being prepared. That's the level of confidence that the family has in the way they prepare food. So there's a fish fry happening here.
Fish fry. Sir, chicken kebab.
Okay. So this is a mutton kurma. Okay. So tell me the recipes that you use. Are they the same recipes that have carried through?
Most of them we use naughty.
So local ingredients, desi, okay.
Kind of organic, not really, really organic.
Not certified organic,
but yeah.
You know, ingredients which are grown locally and in the old-fashioned way.
Yes.
So the recipes here have been handed down through generation, from the first generation to the second, and from the second generation to the third. And the recipes are not noted or written down, it's all transmitted from one mind to another. And I think that's what makes it so precious. Yes, you could say secretive, but I think that's what also makes these recipes so precious. He said this is a treasure that the generations before him have passed on to them, and that is so beautifully said. So I see some trotters here. This is for the leg sweep.
Yeah.
And I can see there's so much of it, so it's probably one of your most popular dishes. And you start serving this early in the morning?
It's available the whole day.
Oh, okay.
Morning 7:30 to late night 10.
So this is the Ragi Mudde, which is a staple.
The most healthiest food of late. They're running behind millets like mad. This we've been running from a long time.
That's right. You know, that's the irony of it. We all talk about superfoods now and Ragi is the rage. But generations ago, this is all that they used to cook, and this is all that they used to eat. This was the ancient wisdom which never really goes out of fashion. Sendil calls it black gold. The mutton chops.
This is tale mamsa fry.
The tale mamsa fry.
Kheema Gojju. Chili chicken.
The Kheema Undo. Is that what you call it?
Kheema Undo. Yeah.
Kheema Undo. Some country chicken. The good stuff, the flavorful chicken as opposed to the broiled. The real chicken, that's right Sendil, it's the real chicken. Namaskara. This is Sendil's mother, the second generation of Ranganna Military Hotel. Yes, Ranganna's wife. New, ella new cook madodu idella.
Okay.
Amele illi nimdu restaurant ishtu popular ide illi.
Chennagide. Mane uta tarane ide.
So I was just speaking with Mrs. Ranganna about what makes it so popular, and she was telling me that it's all about cooking food. When people come here and eat, they feel like they've entered perhaps their homes. It's homely food, that's really what it's all about. So these are the famous Ranganna Military Hotel Pulao. People call them biryanis, but they're actually pulao.
Pulao gets cook together, the meat and the rice gets together.
Either
biryani is not like that. They cook the meat separately, then they put it into dum together.
Whereas here the meat and the rice is cooked together right at the start.
Yeah.
Chanage parimala barta ide biryani idu. Idu swalpa green color ide alla nimdu biryani.
Yeah, whitish. Whitish green.
Whitish green. Yeah. Adu green color eno mention kaya eno baru.
No. That is
secret. Beautiful. And I'm always partial more to a mutton biryani.
ಚಿಕನ್ ಬಂದು ಈಗ ದಿನ ಬಂದಿರೋದು ಮುಂಚೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ಇಲ್ಲ ಯಾವಾಗ ಆವಾಗಲ್ಲ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಮಟನ್
Very interesting. So I just learned from Mrs. Ranganna saying earlier, when you talked about a pulao or a biryani, it only meant mutton or naati chicken, the desi chicken. But it's only now, recent times, that you've got the broiler that's also making its way into the pulao or the biryani. This looks delicious and it smells so good too. I can't wait to get back to the table and taste all the wonderful food that's on offer here at Ranganna Military Hotel. Ondu mutton chops kodi.
Okay.
Amele ondu Kheema unde.
Kheema Gojju.
Haan.
Thale mamsa.
Haan.
One soup.
Haan.
Ondu bangla fish.
Oh, pulao end nalli. Haan. I've ordered about 7 or 8 dishes to taste. Of course, I also have the food lovers team here with me. So, although I will taste some of the dishes, after we finish, after the cameras stop rolling, we will all sit together and eat what I'm hoping and what I'm sure will be a delicious meal here at Ranganna Military Hotel. When we got here to Ranganna Military Hotel, it was almost empty. But if you look now, we're in the midst of lunch and every single table is taken, every single chair is taken. And that's always a happy sign. You know that people are enjoying their military hotel uta. And that's what I'm here for too. So as you can see, I've gone overboard as usual. I couldn't help but order many of these dishes from the menu. From the kitchen here. So I have the Kheema Gojju, which is a preparation made with mutton Kheema. This one is called the Kheema Undo, which is the Kheema balls. I have the Bannur lamb chop, kal soup, or the paya. We also have the chicken leg. I saw some mackerel marinated, kept on the side there. So I said I must have this. And this one is a dish for the hardcore carnivore, the thale mamsa. And of course, we have the wonderful aromatic pulao, and I have asked for the mutton pulao. When you're at Ranganna Military Hotel, the only way to eat all of this is with the ragi mudde, and you have some saru to go with that. So let's get started with the ragi mudde first. Oh, it's nice and soft. Dip it a bit into the saru. So thing with ragi mudde is you don't chew on it, you just swallow it. Everybody talks about ragi, millets as being the new superfood. But ragi mudde has been a way of life for decades now. It's only now the world is discovering the benefits of ragi. I think I'm going to start with the fish. It's a deep fried fish. I love the coating of the fish. It's crunchy, it's spicy, and it also has that lemony twang. And this is one fleshy fish. So you also have the flavors, you have the intense flavors of the bangure or the mackerel that also comes through despite the masala. Definitely a tasty fish. Typically in military hotels you don't find too much fish. So that's why when I saw this fish fry here, I said I must order this. So good. Of course, we also have some soup here, which is the soup from the kal soup. That is the goat leg soup. You can order either the leg soup with the leg, or you can just order the soup as well, which is what I have done. Ah, that's a hearty broth. You can definitely taste the goodness of the bone that's been extracted into this broth. If you're sick, if you're nursing a cold, definitely something that even a doctor would approve. So good. Let's taste the chicken leg. Mm. This is a spicy piece of chicken. It also has some of the skin there. So although this is a broiler chicken, but you have the skin, you have the masala, all of that coming together, giving it that wholesome, full, rich sort of flavor. The chicken is cooked just perfectly. If you look at this piece of meat, it's cooked right down to the bone. And yet, it's not dry. Lovely. I'm going to taste the Kheema Gojju next. You got the mince, and it's a coarse mince. You also see flecks of fat, or is it garlic? I'm not sure. You also have some peas. It's a coarse grind for a Kheema, which is nice because you get the bite of the meat. The Kheema is soaked in all that gravy, all that masala. And these little peas are a nice touch, because they just go pop, they just melt in your mouth. And you also have bits of fat here, which kind of gives it that flavor. This is so good. You know, all around me, there are people dining, but there's an air of near silence. And I think it tells us that people are tucking into their meals. People are enjoying their meals. Kheema Undo next. The food here is certainly spicy. You can taste the spice of the food. So these are Kheema balls in a curry of sorts. So here you can see that the mince is more finer, I think, for it to hold together. It's very different from the Kheema Gojju. In fact, Kheema here is tightly bound together, and there's almost a certain springiness when you bite into the meat. You can taste the flavor of the herbs that have gone in. I think there's a copious amount of coriander that's gone into this gravy here. The mince is ground very fine for it to come together in the form of a nice springy ball that has soaked up all that herby goodness of this gravy here. I'm dunking my piece of ragi mudde into the gravy here, and I'm going to have this with a bite of the Kheema unne, or the Kheema ball. So good. Some fiber in between all that meat. Next, I'm going to try some of this paya soup. So you have all that gelatin that's kind of rendered. You can see the trotters, all that gelatin after the trotter, the paya has been cooked. Very mellow in its flavor. You can taste the goodness of all this paya broth. I think I'm going to drink the broth right from this saucer here. You get that warm, comforting, almost nourishing sort of a feeling on your palate. Beautiful. I have to save my appetite now for the bannur mutton chop. So you can see this is a chop that has the meat, also has a sizable chunk of the fat as well. And I think this is the fat that's rendered from the meat onto that gravy. Lovely. You can taste the flavor of the meat. You can taste the flavor of the meat. And the meat is cooked just fine. This mutton, fittingly enough for a military hotel, has a decent amount of bite. When you have meat and you also have a bit of fat, I think that's the tastiest part of meat. The meat has a bite, but the fat literally melts in your mouth. Beautiful. A little more of the ragi mudde. The saru changes every other day, and I'm told today is a mutton saru. Before I dive into the pulao, I have another dish to try here, which is the tale mamsa curry, or the goat head curry. So you got bits of the goat head, so I can see there's some tongue here. There should also be some brain here, but I Can't seem to find it. Perhaps it's all rendered into the gravy. I'm going to have some of this soft tissue here. I'm not a huge fan of the tale mamsa, but locals swear by the tale mamsa. In fact, it's a delicacy. You've got the soft tissue or the soft bits of the meat here. I think I also tasted some of the goat brain. That literally almost melted in my mouth. The tale mamsa, to be honest, is an acquired taste. Some bits of it, like the tongue, are extremely tough, extremely hard, and I'm not a big fan at all. But the brain and some of the soft tissue is delicious. But it's an acquired taste. And it's for the die-hard carnivore. It's time to go for the mutton pulao. The family calls this the mutton pulao, but on the menu it says mutton biryani because that's what customers are so used to calling anything with meat and rice. So this is the short grain rice, the jeera sambar rice that's gone into this mutton pulao. I'm going to be greedy and go for the meat. This is an aromatic pulao. As you hold the plate closer, you can smell the sweet, gentle aroma of this pulao. The moment your fingers feel the warm touch of the rice and the meat, it creates that yearning on your palate that you immediately want to taste, you want to savor what's in your hand. Out here, they cook the rice and the meat together from scratch, and that's what they say makes it a pulao. And because the rice is cooked with the meat right from the start, you can taste that savory unctuousness of the meat in the rice itself. It's again one of those rice dishes that you can eat just by itself. You have some flecks of coriander, you have flecks of tomato. Let's taste the meat. Despite being cooked in the rice from scratch, and I'm told the process takes about an hour, hour and a half, you still have the bite of the meat intact. But this is a piece of meat that has flavor and definitely has that bite as well. And out here at Ranganna, they don't hold back on the fat. You have pieces of meat with the fat, and I think that brings in, that gives it all that flavor. So there you go, a piece of meat with some fat. More than the meat, I love the flavor of the rice in this mutton pulao. Having tasted all these dishes, and I think I've tasted at least 7 or 8 of them, the food here at Ranganna Military Hotel is pretty much what you would expect in a military hotel. It's hearty, robust, full-on flavored, non-vegetarian fare. But I think Ranganna Military Hotel is very different from other military hotels. And I think that's because of the fact that you've got a culinary legacy of 3 generations that have been tending the fires here. When you walk into the kitchen at Ranganna Military Hotel and you see the lady of the house cooking the pulao, and you see the 3rd generation working on that Kheema Gojju, you know that there's a lot of care, there's a lot of attention from the family that's gone into each one of the dishes out here. And I think that's what makes Ranganna Military Hotel very unique, very special. When you come here, you're not just tasting all these meaty dishes, but you're also tasting a slice of that culinary tradition that's been handed down 1 generation to the other. And I think that's what makes a meal at Ranganna Military Hotel truly special. When you come in here to dine at Ranganna Military Hotel, although it does of course feel like a large establishment, the food here certainly feels very homely. And it's a sort of food that's probably prepared in the homes of Mr. and Mrs. Ranganna. If you're in Nama Bengaluru and if you're in Jayanagara, certainly stop by for a meal at Ranganna Military Hotel. And I think you won't be disappointed. I'm going to go back to that delicious rice in the mutton pulao here at Ranganna Military Hotel. Until the next episode of Gourmet on the Road, stay safe and happy eating.
If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to subscribe, share and leave a comment.
If you'd like to support Food Lovers TV, do log on to foodlovers.in and hit the support Food Lovers banner. Links in the description below. Happy eating!